Well, hi everybody. Thursday, February 4th. Just sitting here looking out the window at an absolutely gorgeous day. It's a blue sky, a few wispy white clouds. There's a couple of basset hounds down on the lawn barking, but they're on the other side. I don't think we can hear them yet, but they may show up. I've got this tree right outside my window that it's lost, you know, all its leaves, but I'm looking out here and there's a bird sitting on here and it's got these little, like, I'm not sure if they're seedlings or flowers on this thing, but they look like little tiny, they're about this small, like a small pea. And I just love sitting here and I look out and the birds are sitting here just having a feast. It's like the blue plate special outside my window, which is really... it's so relaxing watching that. I just really love it. You know, when you can kind of just shut the madness of the world out and enjoy what nature has given us. It's pretty fantastic. It's mesmerizing, I'll say. It's been really nice. I've got a lot of rabbits living in my yard. I don't know where they all came from, but it's so great. Every night I cut up a bunch of apples and take them out, or remove the seeds. I've heard that seeds are bad for them, but the flesh of the apple, and I put them out, and I just lay them out on the lawn, and like within, you know, 5 minutes or so, there's like, you know, 3-4 rabbits out there just having a great old time. Where the hell they are during the day, I have no idea, but I see them out in the backyard, in the front yard, and see them in other neighbors' yards, so it's pretty cool. I love that. Lots of wildlife around here. Let's see, what else is going on? I had mentioned playing along with Carol for her birthday, and then people were kind enough to make note that it wasn't today. I think they put down the 9th for her birthday. So I'll dig through and maybe do a few songs that I recorded with her and played with her on tour. I love Carol. She's a force of nature, I'll say that. She's one fascinating woman. So that'll be fun. But I was kind of going back, once again, into the Wayback Machine here. And I had forgotten about my association working with this gentleman. And so I thought, well, hell, I'm going to play some of his stuff today that I worked on. And that's Roger McGuinn. Now, I think if I'm doing Roger, I should probably... even though I don't have the round ones, you know, he always had those glasses on like that. So maybe I'll just sort of allude to it. I wrote some notes, you know, as I refer to my copious notes. I try to hold on to words like that because I play a lot of Scrabble. And you're always hoping for something like that might grab you a few points, you know, unexpectedly when you see all those mixed up letters on your tray. And you go, oh, copious. I see copious in there. Roger McGuinn, he founded the Birds. He was one of the founding members of the Birds back in 1964. So he goes way back in this, and he was involved in a lot of things before that. He has a remarkable history that's worth looking up. He was, in 1968, he was part of a project called Sweetheart of the Rodeo with Chris Hillman and Graham Parsons. And the thing that's interesting to me is when I look back at the Birds, I mean, I was a huge Birds fan. I love them. And when I look back to the members of it, we got Roger McGuinn, we got Gene Clark, David Crosby, Chris Hillman, Clarence White, Michael Clark, and Graham Parsons. Now, Clarence White and Graham Parsons were part of slightly later incarnations, I believe. But the thing I enjoy about it is I was such a fan of them, and then to have done an album, a couple of projects with Roger, having done No Other with Gene Clark, which is such a fantastic album, done so many projects with David Crosby over the years, worked with Chris Hillman and Herb Peterson on projects that they were doing. And I was working with Clarence White when he was killed in an accident. We were in the studio at that time. So, you know, it's just interesting to me how these histories, when I look back, how commingled they are and connected with all these people. Certainly, I still have just the utmost admiration for all these people. And it breaks my heart that Clarence is gone and Gene's gone and, you know, and Graham's gone. And just, wow, you know. But a lot of history, a lot of legacy. One of the projects I did with Roger was an album called Peace on You. And we did that in 1974. So that goes way back. And I put together a list of all the characters on that. And for me, seeing that also kind of just blows my mind a little bit. So we had Roger playing guitar, of course. And Roger created, I think, anytime I hear a Rickenbacker 12 string, I just immediately think of Roger. That it became such a signature sound with him. And he played it so amazingly. So he's playing guitar vocals on this thing. Dan Fogelberg is playing guitar and vocals on this with him. And I worked with Dan. Al Cooper's playing keyboards, and I've been with Al forever. Jorge Calderon is singing, one of the background singers on this, who was very involved with Warren Zevon for so many years. Tim Coulter singing background. Now, Donnie Dacus is playing guitar, and I used to do a lot of sessions with Donnie back in the day. Brenda Gordon on background vocals. Paul Harris playing keyboards, and I worked on a number of projects with Paul Harris. Tommy Tedesco is playing guitar on this, and I did lots of stuff with Tommy, and still one of my favorite people I've ever known in my life. Al Perkins playing steel, who I've worked with many, many times, and Russ Kunkel is on drums here. This is great. Two of the other background singers are Howard Kalin and Mark Volman, Flo and Eddie, who I worked with them, but they were the Turtles. So all these things are just kind of mashed together. And William Smith and Gwen Edwards and Brock Honeycutt are also singing background. So there's a big cast of characters on this project. But it's really kind of defines that, you know, early mid 70s sound. And I really enjoyed it. It was a really fertile period in Los Angeles, certainly. You had all these great writers, J.D. Souther, and you had, you know, the groups like, you know, the Flying Burrito Brothers and Poco and the Eagles forming out of all of that. And just so many remarkable artists and such an intense, it's kind of ridiculous, one of these things, such a fertile and intense period of music. And I am forever grateful that I was here to be a part of it, because it was an incredible community and a really giving community. I think that was one of the things that made it so wonderful, is that at any given time, and I've talked about this so many times, you'd go to somebody's house or go to the studio, and there would be people there that really weren't necessarily part of that project from the standpoint of who was, you know, hired to do it. But they would just show up, and next thing you know, they're saying, oh, you want to sing background vocals on this? You want to throw a guitar part on this? And people just all, you know, gave to each other. It was a remarkable community. So I think I got a helicopter. Oh, it was weird this morning. Near where I live, there's a main boulevard that's got a big wide curve in it. And you know, once again, you know, it's a 35 mile an hour speed limit, and there's always idiots going like 60 miles an hour. And I was walking the dogs this morning, and all of a sudden I hear skidding, and I see this car spinning, doing donuts down the street. This guy had been speeding like crazy and came around this curve and totally lost it, and then drifted. Thank God there were no other cars out. Drifted across and T-boned into a pole in there. And the car was, tires were smoking, and just, I mean, it was just unbelievable. And then I see him kind of back up a bit, and then he speeds off. I mean, it didn't see anybody chasing him, but there are so many crazy people in this world. Just keep your eyes open, stay careful. I was grateful he wasn't on the side of the street that I was on with the dogs, even though I was removed from the sidewalk. I was farther back, walking on an area that's in from the street. But when you hear this skidding and you see smoke from tires skidding down the street, it was unbelievable. You know, I was, you know, concerned for the person, and then I see them just kind of get the car going again, and I see the whole side of it's caved in. And they went back down, you know, kept on going. What can I say? Let's play some music. So this is the title track from Roger McGuinn's album called Peace on You. So let's take a listen and see what things were like back in 1974 when this was all still brown and there was still stuff here. Please.
Everything in life is a negotiation. When you cross the street is a negotiation.
I have to address this. Screw that. I'm going to go back to the start again. I hate that. I've got to upgrade this. Sorry. Else sings like him either. It's a different voice.
Thank you.
was always great when they would get like all those different, all the different singers to come into the studio, and they'd all gather around a mic and grab their little headphone, and they'd do these background parts. Was really cool, you know, to see a room full. That's the, again, the times where I regret not having a camera with me. And God, it would have been so great to have had an iPhone from day one. I so regret not having documented so much of, you know, I was around over all these years. But it was fun. You know, you'd see this room, just everybody'd show up and be hanging out. It was just great. This tune, let's see what we got here. This one's called The Lady. And we'll just check out another one. This is still Roger McGuinn. Yeah, his voice is so unique. He's just, his enunciation, the way the timbre of his voice is really something very different. The minute I hear him, I know who it is. Here we go. This is called The Lady.
Ready?
Oh, no, this is called The Commercial. I'm going to scream. I sign up with ad blocker, and still I'm getting crap. There's that Rickenbacker 12 string. So birds-like. Heard this in decades. Wow.
Grow and they made a
Gotta love playing with Russ Kunkel. He just, his pocket's so, just so solid and so strong, but so creative too. I mean, that felt so much, you know, of the Birds ilk, and really cool. I haven't heard this in so long. It's interesting. That's one of the things I've been finding fascinating about doing this channel, is just revisiting things that for me are 30, 40, 50 years removed, and just checking out, and then memories come back about the sessions and all the people there and studios. As I think about to so many studios that no longer exist in Los Angeles, where they were like second homes to all of us. And it was so heartbreaking when you'd see them shuttered and down, and then suddenly the building's gone. And you know, it's either been bulldozed down for something else, or it is so totally changed that, you know, there's no semblance of what you knew from your days there. So I'll do one more song, see what this one is. This is Without You. See what kind of vibe we got. Hopefully no commercial. It's weird. I put in ad blocker and I still get ads. So I guess I may have to upgrade to premium YouTube or whatever it is to get it. But it's so annoying. You're just starting, all of a sudden the screen goes black and then somebody's selling you something for constipation or I don't know. It's ridiculous. Here we go. There was no one else but you. This is called Without You. From the moment that we met, foolish dreams were coming true. Oh, look, here we go.
Why the U.S. Privacy Commission wants this new super lens band.
Ooh, ooh. Is so LA early 70s. It's amazing. Go Russ.
Of you here. He could tell me what was wrong.
long fades.
Wow.
It's amazing how much real estate a Hammond organ can take up in a track. You know, it's just big. I'm sure that was probably Al Cooper playing organ there. I love the way Al played. He's just big sound. Between Al Cooper, between the B3 and a 12-string Rickenbacker, it's a full sound. It's great. Really fun. Wow. I think that should do it for right now. I was very happy. I finally heard back from Ian Pace, and he was really happy with the track I sent him. And I wanted to make sure that was in the ballpark before I went on to the other tunes. And he said, no, get going. So I'm going to, I've got some more files of songs I'm going to upload or download into GarageBand, the next one, and get to work and try to get him off another song or two today. And I've got some stuff to do for Judith Owen also. And it seems like lots of things. I've already been to the post office this morning, and somebody bought one of my posters that I painted, and Blue just dropped it off at the house here because he's the one, his company does the printing, and I'll do those as ordered. I'm not going to have an inventory sitting around because they're really really high quality printing on them, the paper, everything. So I'm going to go ahead, sign it, number it, and get that in the mail to its new home. And I'm excited about that. And that's about it. I got a full day ahead. So I wish everybody a great day. And I had a great Zoom yesterday with a college down in Alabama. I think it's called Stamford, I believe. I had it all written down, but I don't have it in front of me right now. But some really cool interview questions, talking about the business and, you know, future of it, the past, and all that. That was great, and had a real fun Zoom interview before that. And I've got another one today at 5 o'clock, and I got two more tomorrow. I mean, every day it's that format. Now, who would have thought Zoom would have been part of our vernacular on a daily basis? But man, it's like, thank God for that, because I got a lot of things going on that, and some stuff. I have to order a green screen now, because for our next we had wanted to do for our next immediate family video a performance one, but it's just we can't do it where we were. We had an opportunity to do something, but somebody, not in the band, but somebody involved in production might have tested positive. So we just said, we just can't do this. So we're going to be back doing our individual things, and then they will be assembled by Mike, who puts all our videos together from all of the pieces of stuff we send him. It's like an accountant getting a bag of receipts and trying to make sense of it. But we have a kind of a concept, and it's going to require a green screen. So I'm going to go and look up some kind of a halfway decent one, and then maybe I'll put it behind me one day. And what I'll do is I'll take a picture of the room behind me, and then I'll put a green screen up with exactly what's behind me on there, and then we'll have contests to guess which one is real, which one is Memorex or something like that. So take good care. I will see everybody tomorrow, and Saturday again is the Skype and FaceTime one-on-ones, and I'm really looking forward to catching up with everybody there. I've got a mustache here that's flipped up, and it tickles me, so I keep going like this. It's driving me nuts. Again, my brother-in-law is doing much better. I took him I dropped off a big box of See's candy last night. He loves nuts and chews, so I thought maybe that would help the healing process. So I got him a 2-pound box of nuts and chews and dropped them off on the front porch, and then knocked and ran. And so they got them. And thank you again to all of the people working. at it, you know, just every day. Some numbers have stabilized a little bit, but it's still a battle every day against this terrible disease. So don't let your guard down. Stay safe. Protect yourself, your family, and your friends, and your community, and we will get through this. So all my best wishes, everybody. You take good care, and I'll see you tomorrow. Okay? Bye-bye.